Hello, YouTube. Welcome to the first kind of episode-ish Web Slinger Nice Time review. Today, we'll be looking at the Hasbro Spider-Man Trilogy Superposable Spider-Man. Okay, so here's the figure. Yeah, it may look crappy. Sorry for the for how the video looks. I assure you, the blue is way brighter. Don't get confused with the Marvel Legends Hasbro Sandman series Spider-Man. Two completely different things. Same kind of body sculpt, just tweaked colors to look more like Spider-Man 3 Spider-Man. Yeah, he looks really, really good. I mean, Hasbro did their homework well. I mean, I got this at a flea market for pretty cheap. And I know the original figure comes with a gargoyle stand. I already had the same gargoyle. It was just a reuse of the Spider-Man 1 Superposable Spider-Man figure, which had the gargoyle stand for you to display him on. So I will find it, and if you want to see that, if you want to see a review of the Superposable Spider-Man for Spider-Man 1, just send the comments below. There you go. I can do requests. Just if I have the money. No, I will take requests. It just will take long. But I will assure you, we will get those. Articulation. Head moves up and down. Turns, but it can do a 360, but I can't do a 360 with the camera like this. His arms do move up and down, in and out, up and down. Bend at the joint. Rotate, let's see if I can get this here. Rotate 360 degrees around the forearm. The fingers have their own articulation. They're all separate, just like these. Spider-Man 2. Spider-Man. Sorry, it's all like shaky cam, Dark Knight. Well, Batman began actually, but oh well. Different films. Here, his head moves 3 inches degrees. Just don't break him. Like I was almost going to. His arms move 360 degrees. Yes. Pardon me. Bear with me if this. I don't have a tripod. I need to get one. Yeah, they go 360 degrees. As you just saw there, his torso can bend in and out. Goes 360 degrees for the waist. He's very stiff because I had not played with it that much. Because I really like this guy. And most of my other ones are worn out and used so many other times. Don't worry, some of the stuff will get edited. As you can tell, he's got nice detail. I mean, yeah, his legs go up and down. They turn 160 degrees around the ankle, and they pivot in 2 points in the foot, for the toes, and the actual foot at the ankle joint, wherever it is. It bends 2 points at the knee. See where those two little screw things are? Get a good shot of it. Not as blurry focused. Yeah, I mean, he looks really good. I mean, they got the raised webs done right, like in the Toy Biz version. Which is pretty much what it is. The Toy Biz version of... The Hasbro version of the Toy Biz Spider-Man 2. They just reused that for the Legends line and Trilogy line. That's all it is. He looks really nice. His eyes look really great. If you can see it well. I try not to make this all blurry. I mean, his spider looks excellent. And they actually got, like, all the details just phenomenal. And I'm glad you can use the... You don't have to use that two-finger web thing. That always bothered me because I didn't always want Spider-Man webbing. I just wanted, like, you know, closed fist. Like, I'm going to beat the crap out of you and stuff, you know. But, all in all, it's a good toy. If you can find it still, if anyone still sells it, I get a flea market or a comic book convention or, you know, any place they sell toys at, I would suggest getting it. It's a very good toy. And if you want to do stop motion, I suggest that if you're into the movie stuff, but if you're into the comic books mostly, I would actually use the comic book Marvel Legends. So yeah, this, comment, rate, subscribe if you like this, and I assure you there'll be more, just a little slow going out, but this is the first one. So this is Webslinger 1990, signing out, man.